Morning, everyone. Up early as usual. 4:30, 5 o'clock is my norm. When the insomnia is full force and I'm not medicated, it could be 3. Yeah, definitely. So anyway, I was watching videos on trust, catching up on those this morning to fortify myself. Getting ready for my court date today, and trust is a huge issue for me. I've gone from trusting to absolutely paranoid non-trust, if that makes sense. At the first sign of any sort of manipulation, coercion, passive-aggressive tones in someone's voice, I literally just like hold up my hand and go, stop, stop talking, and walk away. I mean, it's such a trigger for me. And of course, if they're a narcissist or any type of abusive personality, they're gonna say, "What's wrong with you? You know, I didn't do anything. I didn't say anything. You're crazy," you know, that sort of thing. And it's just like, no, I can tell, but my reaction is still somewhat of an overreaction. So anyway, trust, that's a huge issue for me, and don't know if I'll ever get past that one. I was watching Finally Free from Narcissism, and she was talking about how she survived each and every time she's gotten away from a narcissist. And her incredible story of even leaving the country and surviving. Incredible courage. I think I'm going to borrow some strength from her because I just can't see myself doing it. I'm with this smothering narcissist. And actually did get to a place of learned helplessness. Especially when I was sick, and he was doing everything for me, even to the point where I'm like, well, I can do this for myself. No, I'll do it, you know. And then to the point where I actually heard the words, "What are you going to do without me?" Even though I've been living in this house alone for some unknown reason for so many years. You think that would be a good thing, right? 'Cause my narcissist isn't living in the house, but it's not. It's terribly isolating, confusing, confounding, and he won't talk to me. He won't tell me all those years what he was doing or why he was doing this. I was literally just waiting for him to make a decision or tell me, you know, hey, I'm moving back in, or we can work this out, or something, anything. But of course, I was left dangling in the air, constantly wondering. Narcissists love to create an air of uncertainty, and that breeds fear. And so uncertainty is what my narc is very good at. So he made me very dependent on him, encouraged that dependence. And I fell for it, hook, line, and sinker. There were a lot of variables, such as, you know, being sick for a very, very long time, and knowing that he's my husband and he was taking care of me, you know, but it was not in a healthy way whatsoever. And the more I rebelled, the more he came down on me. So anyway, I'm still at a crossroads. I'm still at that cognitive dissonance, and I know there's some people here who've gone through this. Marriage meant a lot to me, being married and staying married, especially to my narcissist. He was the one. I would have stayed with this guy forever in spite of the things he did to me, which is incredibly crazy, isn't it? There were some horrible things he's done to me, and usually all behind my back. And part of me just still thinks, wow, you know, we can get back together and start over. I know. It's crazy. And I know that that's not healthy. But that's part of my mind that I struggle with. Maybe a lot of that's out of fear of uncertainty and fear that I can't make it on my own, which is ridiculous because I know that I can. I just don't feel it, you know? I just feel so dependent, you know? But I gotta make the move. I do. But I'm still struggling, even this morning, with having to go to divorce court. With, I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this. I want the guy I dated back. You know, I want a marriage. I want what I always wanted with him. But that's not possible because I know who he is now. I know what he's done. And they don't stop. They're compulsive, so that never ends. He's sadistic. That's not going to stop. And it's like asking a lion to be something other than a lion. You know? It's very confusing. So I know maybe some people out there are still struggling with the cognitive dissonance. Remember now, I've been in this relationship for 22 years, all together, including dating and such. So it's really a mind fuck, let me tell you. So listening to everyone's videos who are putting them out, excuse me, is very fortifying, encouraging, and it reminds me that of the person, the full person I know that I can be. I just lost it somewhere, most of me. Anyway, before I go rambling on and not making any sense, I just wanted to put that out there this morning, and I hope that helps someone today. Peace out.